الله يحفظكم يا رب. جاهزون إن شاء الله.
طيب نبدأ.
على بركة الله، بسم الله، بس خلي الكاميرا أون أهم شيء.
أنت تراني؟
الكاميرا عندك أظني أوف.
كيف صارت؟ نعم تمام، خير إن شاء الله،
خير بإذن الله. بسم الله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. Dear brothers and sisters, الحمد لله. It's a pleasure to be again with you tonight. We have just completed the 16th day of Ramadan in the year 2020. So again, the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are enormous upon us, and this is the month of the Quran. We should be enjoying the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while we are in the shades of the Quran, and while we are looking at the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how they impact us and how we should feel about them and how we should react when we read them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ بَصَائِرُ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ فَمَنْ أَبْصَرَ فَلِنَفْسِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent you things to see. The ones who can see, it is for your own. And the ones who do not see, وَمَنْ عَمِيَ فَعَلَيْهَا. The ones who do not see, they are the ones who are losing. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us and guide us and to help us see the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the more important things that we all understand is that as this is the month of the Quran, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explains to us that أهل القرآن أهل الله وخاصته, or the people of the Quran are the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are his people. And of course, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us that, he doesn't mean the people who just memorize without understanding. But it is the people who memorize and understand. And more important than memorize, really understand the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because as we understand the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we get to appreciate the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as it is the wahi of Allah Almighty. And one of the most important things for us to understand is Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, the meaning of Alhamdulillah. How can we really be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? As we know, the first word that Adam alayhi salam said after he sneezed was Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. So Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, this is something that we need to understand and internalize. What is the first ayah that we find in Surah Al-Fatiha? Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. So what is Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen? What does it mean for us to have Alhamd to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And what is the meaning of Alhamd? So the scholars say it combines two things. One of them is to be glorifying Allah. And the second thing is to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we understand, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one with the attributes, the 99 names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Ghani, Al-Kareem, Al-Hamid, Al-Rafi', Al-Hasib. Al-Mu'min, Al-Salam, Al-Mu'min, Al-Muhaymin, Al-Aziz, Al-Jabbar, all these beautiful names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us that we need to glorify him. So we glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we listen to his attributes and his names, which he deserves, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us all kinds of things. So he gave us as-sam'a wal-absara wal-afidat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the ability to hear, the ability to see, and the hearts where we could feel, where we could think, and we could ponder upon things. So we need to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to glorify Allah and to thank Allah, these two things, you put them together and you come up with Alhamd. So Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, the creator of the heavens and the earth, the one who has given us everything. Now, one of course of the issues that people face is that they have what we say. They say Alhamdulillah, not really understanding what it means, or not reflecting on it, or just say Alhamdulillah with the mouth without really reflecting in the heart and in the mind of what it really means. For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, Isbir wa ma sabruka illa billah. Be patient, and your patience comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wasta'inu bis sabri was salah. Seek help from Allah by patience and prayer. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا الصَّبْرُ عِنْدَ الصَّدْمَةِ الْأُولَى. Truly, patience is at the first shock. at the first shock. When the first shock comes to you, that's when you show the patience. And Allah, Rasulullah also, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, لَيْسَ الشَّدِيدُ بِالصُّرَعَةِ إِنَّمَا الشَّدِيدُ الَّذِي يَمْلِكُ نَفْسَهُ عَنْدَ الْغَضَبِ. That the strong person is not the one who just fights with everybody. No. The strong person is the one who controls his anger. The one who controls his anger. يَمْلِكُ نَفْسَهُ عَنْدَ الْغَضَبِ. Now, when these things happen to us, and we reflect on alhamd, and a calamity happens, you directly go to Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Why? Because you are connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to practice patience in that way is a type of Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. And also, assuming that somebody bothers you or somebody hurts you or somebody says something bad to you, you're hurt and you want to respond, but you take it upon yourself that I am not going to respond. Not because I am weak, but because I am taking control of the situation. And that is another type of alhamd. And that exactly what gives us the internal relief that we can internalize, that we can feel that yes, truly we are hamidun to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are people who have that reflection on the true word of glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, thanking him and being able to respond, but we don't, so that we are truly thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And of course, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, as we can see from the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to start everything with Alhamd. Of course, Al-Quran starts with Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever he speaks, he says, Inna alhamdulillahi nahmaduhu ta'ala wa nastaghfiruhu wa nasta'inuhu. And when you want to do Salatul Hajj, you start with Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Because it's athana, you glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before you ask him anything. Another thing is that when you think of the true attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you realize how great it is to just be calling upon the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Ghafur, ighfir lana. Ya Rahim, irhamna. Ya Qadir, qaddirna. Ya Ghani, aghnina. All these things, you call the attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then you call it upon yourself to be thankful for that thing. And then also, when we look at everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to us. So Allah Almighty, now, of course, you know, we could reflect in the month of Ramadan and see, like, what are the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to us in the month of Ramadan? Truly, we have a situation outside, but mashallah, we are inside our homes. We had food for ourselves. We have food for the family. We are not in shortage that there will not be food tomorrow. We will be sleeping fine tonight. We have a bed to sleep on. We have plenty of food. We have peace. There's no war around us. We have all kinds of things to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to have alhamd. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us that if you man bata aminan fi sirbihi indahu quwtu wa yawmihi mu'afan fi badanihi, you have your home for the night, you have your food for the day, and you have your body healthy, then you can imagine. Unfortunately, yesterday we lost one of the great sisters in this community, and we all feel sad for that. And we also remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we still have what we have. We haven't lost. And when we see the loss of a close brother and the loss of a sister that were with us for like 20 plus years, and we can see how that impacts us, and we recall, yes, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, for all the things that Allah Almighty has given to us. And also, the other thing, for example, you know, my head is moving. You go to sleep. What happens to you when you go to sleep? As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, Allah yatawaffa al-anfusa hina mawtaha wallati lam tamut fi manamiha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala receives the souls that die. And the souls, when people, they go to sleep. So going to sleep by itself and waking up the next day is something that really to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To have alhamdulillah, I woke up today. Alhamdulillah, I can stand on my own feet. Alhamdulillah, the blood is still flowing on my veins. Alhamdulillah, I can be cognizant of what's around me. I could look around me, I could see, I could stand up and I could walk. Imagine if you go to sleep and the next day you wake up without one of these things. You wake up without the ability to see, la samahallah, Allah not willing. And all these things that Allah Almighty has given to us. That's why it is very important. Every day when we wake up, need to internalize, need to think, look, I got all these things. And I need to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Allah Almighty says in the Quran, إِنَّ السَّمْعَ وَالْبَصَرَ وَالْفُؤَادَ كُلُّ أُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ عَنْهُ مَسْؤُولًا. The السَّمْعَ, the hearing, the seeing, and the heart, you are going to be asked about those things because they're just great things to have. And when we want to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for them, we really need to think deeply when we say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, because we want to have that close connection between our mind, our tongue, and our heart. It's not that we say something with our tongue that is not connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything that is moving in us, like, you know, the heart is beating, the nails are growing. Imagine if your nails stop growing. You will have a big problem. You will have a big disaster. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is continuously, is as Allah Almighty says, Al-Khallaq. So Allah is Al-Khallaq. You are being created every second. The cells in our bodies are being created every second. The fluids in our system, everything is being created every second. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Khallaq. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stops these things from happening, we will have a huge problem. And of course, the biggest of all problems, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes our soul away, we are not ready to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will be a big disaster. So Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen is really to think about all of these things as we are uttering those words from our mouth. And as we say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, we need to think that, yes, truly, I am thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the glorified one, the Lord of the heavens and the earth. I want to feel those things. I don't just want to say it with my own tongue, but I want to feel it. And that is the true servitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are servants of Allah Almighty. And then the closer we get to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the better people we are going to be. And the month of the Quran, that's exactly what it is. So when we look in the Quran and we read the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is the Quran? It tells us about Allah. So as the Quran tells us about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we get to read, as like, you know, one time Umar ibn Khattab, a man came to be a witness for him. So he asked him, did you travel with this person? He said, no. He said, did you deal with him with money, like back and forth? He said, no. He said, then you do not know him because you are not close to him. So وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْعَلَى. So if we are to be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's exactly what we need to do. We need to look into the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we need to read those words. We need to read those ayat. It's not how much we read. Of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is generous that he gives us al-hasanatu bi'ashri amthaliha. And every letter that we read will get 10 hasanat. But that is like step number one. It's only step number one. What about if you start to understand what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you? Ya ayyuhal insan, ma gharraka bi rabbikal kareem. When you read those ayat, oh mankind, how come you do not appreciate your Lord? I mean, Allah is telling us, he's telling you, when you read this, like Allah is talking to you. Ya ayyuhal insan, oh mankind, ma gharraka bi rabbikal kareem. How come you are not appreciative of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And you think things are just that simple? No. We need to reflect. We need to understand those things, all of them. And also, to be truly appreciative of Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen means that we understand what Al-Quran is telling us. This is halal, we stop. That is Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. This is halal, we do. That is Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. The fact that we follow the footsteps of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the fact that we follow what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the commandments of Allah in the Quran, we follow them one by one, that is a true hamd of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are thanking him and we are appreciating him, and all this light that is coming from the Quran will become the light of our hearts, will become the light of our minds. And that is how we need to reflect on that. When we say La ilaha illallah, that in itself is Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. To reflect upon the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a great thing. So when we reflect on that, we also understand that is a true hamd of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the true practice of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the true practice of the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, staying away from al-bid'ah. Staying away from al-bid'ah. When somebody tells you this is a bid'ah, And of course, you have to make sure that it is a bid'ah. And when you know that something is a bid'ah and you stay away from it, that is a true practice of Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. So the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are to be practiced. They are not just to be heard with our ears, but to live them in our life. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kana Qur'an and yamshi. How was he Qur'an and yamshi? He was Qur'an and yamshi, or a walking Qur'an, because he was the internalization and the implementation and the practice of the hududullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that are in the Qur'an. All of that is the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the great month of the Qur'an that we really need to understand. And finally, I will just leave you with this word. إِنَّمَا يَخْشَ اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءُ. The true people who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the knowledgeable people of Him. So if we read and we do not understand and we do not get the knowledge, then we are not really fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the more we get to know Allah, the closer we know to Allah, then we will be inshallah among the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا يَخْشَ اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءُ. Truly the people who know Allah fear Him most. And the more we know, the more we fear. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us in this month and to give us the ability to dig into the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to dig into those words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to read them, to understand them, and to practice them in our lives. Jazakumullahu khayran, wa assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Fi aman.
Wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Hayyakum.